my studio. I'm Linda Peterson, and I'm back with another Spellbinders Media Mixáge video. Today's topic is explore beyond, and that's a phrase that you hear quite a lot associated with Spellbinders. And what we're going to do today is we're going to explore beyond basic shapes. So we're going to turn heart die templates into flowers. We'll begin by creating our largest flower, and to do that you'll need these two dies. These are from the Spellbinders Media Mixáge line. These are the hearts too. This is the number 2 and the number 3, with one being the smallest. I also have a flower die here from the Jewels Flower and Flourishes collection, and so you can see I've got my cutting plate. I have my aluminum here from a soda can. I have my dies with cutting side down. You're going to complete that with your base plate and pass this through the Artisan X-plorer machine. You'll need to repeat that process 6 times for the larger petals. You'll need 5 of the smaller hearts, and then you'll need 1 jewel flower for each flower that you're going to create. Now the next step that I do is I spray paint these, and I love to use the Krylon spray paint. You can choose any color. Here I'm using Ballet Slipper, and I've also used a gray to spray paint my smaller hearts. And I like to distress, so take a little bit of that paint off with a sanding sponge just to kind of reveal a little bit of the metal underneath. Next I ink up the edges. And really, you can do this with any color that you want. I just like brown because I like that age vintage look. For the larger flowers, I like to give them a little bit of extra shape. So I have a knitting needle here, and what I'm going to do is coil my heart tips here, the back of the heart, the scallops, backwards a little bit. And then I'm also going to use a pencil to roll up the bottom of the petal so you get something that looks like this. And I add a little bit more shape because I want to curve the petal in, so I'm going to make a little snip towards the bottom here. Just make sure that you don't snip all the way through and cut off your point. That's what it looks like. And then I'm going to slightly bend these in and up. And that creates my petal. You're going to repeat this for each of your petals. Here I have a couple of dimensional tacky dots that I've put one on top of each other. I'm just making that adhesive space a little bigger. And now we're going to apply our petals. So I've already begun with this one here. You're going to do this in a clockwise pattern. And you just lay your petals onto those tacky dots and press down. Now you'll need to do some arranging with these. Get them the way you like. And when you finish, it should look something like this. Now it's time to assemble our flower, and you can see I've done the exact same thing, except this is with the smaller hearts. There's 5 petals here, and really this could be a standalone flower as well. So you have a lot of options to mix and match. I also have this secured onto a tacky dot that I'll press right in the center of my larger petals. I have inked the edges of my jewel flourishes, which will also go down into the center. And I'm going to follow that up. This is an old broken brooch that I have had for quite a while, and I'll glue that all down. Now once I have this all arranged, I like to glue it securely with a little bit of 2-part epoxy. And let me show you what they look like on the finished project. Now this is actually a jewelry organizer that I made from an upcycled kitchen grate, and I've embellished the front side of it. You can see I've added a little bit of lace. I have a vintage postcard that I got in Paris, and of course I've decorated it with my gorgeous soda can flowers, my upcycled flowers. The Spellbinders Media Mixáge line makes it so easy to create beautiful mixed media works of art. So how awesome is it that you can take a simple heart shape and turn it into a beautiful flower? You can check out the entire line of the Spellbinders Media Mixáge on their website at spellbinderscreativearts.com. That's going to wrap it up for this episode, but I'll be back again to share more tips, techniques, and ideas, because the possibilities are endless when you explore beyond.